Oh, hello. I was just reading one of my favorite books, the Kevin James Bible. It's one of my all-time favorite reads, right up there with my book, Barbara Dixon's Think Thin. 33-minute slow cooker sandwiches for a slender self and thinner thighs. It's out of print, and I couldn't record the audiobook version of it because the narrator had a nervous breakdown. I've always identified with Jesus Christ. Oh, I know it might be considered incredibly blasphemous to say so, but me and old JC have a whole hell of a lot in common. Back in my musical theater days, I, like Jesus, had 12 devoted single men who followed me everywhere. In today's parlance, we'd call them my gays. I, too, had a cherished friend who stabbed me in the back after a fateful supper. I'll never forgive you, Mandy Patinkin. You stuck me with our bar tab at Bimmelman's in 82. You're a bastard, and I love you. And just like the Lord and Savior, my mother was also a virgin when I was conceived. Well, a backdoor one. It counts. Happy Easter, gang. And hey, happy birthday, Jesus. Cheers. Hot. If the Easter spirit has grabbed you by your furry little peeps, then it's time to make pysanka, the traditional Ukrainian Easter egg. All you need are farm-fresh eggs, beeswax, a handmade stylus, decades of artisanal training, and a series of dyes made from dried roots, berries, and insects. But first things first, let's remove the yolk without cracking the shell. You know how to do that, don't you? Just put your lips together and blow. As pie. Next step, separate the egg white from the yolk, add lemon juice, simple syrup, club soda, and 1.5 fingers of gin. Ta-da! A refreshing gin fizz. Don't forget to throw the unused yolk on your doorstep to ward off Vidma, a traditional Ukrainian witch who will otherwise destroy your crops and kill your livestock. And that's how you make a traditional egg for your Easter. Mazel tov. Memories. You know, growing up, Easter was always a special time in my house, even though we didn't have a lot. But as they say, when the good Lord deals you a turd hand, you use the other hand to wipe. So throughout the year, I'd hoard loose chocolate chips, stray buttons, and stale taffy, roll them into oblong wads of wet toilet paper, and ta-da! Instant Easter eggs. And I wanted to bring just a little bit of that Dixon family Easter magic to you. That's right, I'm spreading open Barbara's grassy basket. 6, 7, 8! Here's some eggs you can call your own. Happy Easter. Filled with treats from Barbara's home. Happy Easter. This one's pink, and you might think it's full of pennies and dimes. But if you crack it, there's a ketchup packet. Happy Easter to you. Here's an egg for a handsome gent. Happy Easter. It's filled with a wad of my dryer lint. Happy Easter. I think this is a lovely dozen. Maybe you'll think so too. Some of these eggs will give you the clap. Happy Easter to you. Happy Easter. Happy Easter. Happy Easter to you. Thank you. Thank you for it.